Going to make it. It will all change eventually. But luck will not be my ally and everything will be very difficult. I don't know what I'm hoping to find, but what else can I do? I will hopefully see if one of these graves is hiding something. I hope that the infrared film will show me. I need the tripod, lens, and infrared film to take the photo I need of the grave. I need the tripod, lens, and infrared film to take the photo I need of the grave. I need the tripod, lens, and infrared film to take the photo I need of the grave. What is this place? This never used to be here. Another entrance, maybe? My dress. It could be the element that links my world with that of the lady. It has been here for a few days, in a place that is both mine and hers. Without all the necessary elements, there's no point travelling to the island. Without all the necessary elements, there's no point travelling to the island. Without all the necessary elements, there's no point travelling to the island. The yellow filter. If it were to snow, it would be perfect. The green filter. Useful for landscapes. What is this? A joke? Maybe someone wrote on the film? Also, what does that even mean? Light, like divine light? Something to do with religion, maybe? There's the grave I've been searching for, and the spirit of a prisoner. Just like the White Lady, he's trapped in this world, but they can no longer meet one another. Evil is separating them. If I wear this, it should allow me to make contact with her. With this object, she'll have to hear me, I have no doubt. Now that I have everything I need to communicate with the lady, I can finally go to the island. The lover's necklace. What a beautiful place. As revenge, the oppressed people grab the slaughterer by the throat. Adolf Hitler, the Italian Communist Party. Revenge for Lapo. This is the tree the lover was hung from, according to the legend. A roll of film. It's the one that I was taking out of the camera just before I discovered Martha's body. It should contain shots from before that moment. With a bit of luck, one of the shots has captured the moment of Martha's murder. I will then finally have an answer. Was it really Mummy? I will develop it as soon as I can, but now it's time to speak with the White Lady. I will wear her lover's cross to draw her to me. A lock of my hair to enter into her world. I will use the tarot cards to communicate with her. The first 10 will be used like I did with Nanny. Once 2 cards have been chosen, it should begin.
You camouflage yourself in the woods to approach me. You blend in with the water to make yourself known. You wish to communicate with me through the energy of symbols. You use my pain to summon me. You are very bold. You call upon me for knowledge that I do not possess. For answers I do not have. I am only a vessel, like water, like air, a vessel to move and breathe.
It worked. Now I need to choose 2 cards. Here we go.
You do not have control of yourself. There is a dark figure inside you. The wounds are feeding it. It will do things you do not like. It will use your desires, your guilt, the darkest parts of your conscience. Part of our soul embraces the people we love. It is then torn away from us when these people disappear. The wound is deep and it cannot heal. Faith vacillates. Death causes fear. But the church is a safe place. It is home and mother to its children. Faith is the light. Do not lose it. Finding it again is almost impossible. I lost it in sorrow, and without time, I am lost in the dark. The daughter, the house, the mother. The daughter comes from the mother's house, then makes herself a home and becomes a mother. This cycle is broken. To undo the knot, find the son. He is the original sin reflected on you. The one who gave you the light wishes to take it back. She wants control. Bit by bit, she is crumbling your life. You have to stop her. You will no longer be able to tell light from darkness. In sorrow, the difference is so subtle. You are alone, and you will remain alone. Memories are abandoning you. They are your only true companions. Now they take the place of your happy childhood, and they may return to keep you company. I can sense that you want to know who did it, but I do not have the answer. You must find it yourself. Do not ever try to enter through the front door if you wish to reach the heart. Your twin sister might have the answer you are looking for. Even after death, we leave traces of ourselves. Don't we? Everything is indefinite if you look at the essence of things.
Speaking with the White Lady confused me even more, but at least now I have this key. July 16th. Dear sister, I entrust my secrets to this letter. If you are reading it, things have gone as I thought they might, and I'm no longer there with you. First of all, I am not deaf, and I never was. Mother scared me when we were little, so I decided not to speak or listen anymore. It worked. In fact, Mother began to love me. They also found a scientific explanation for my deafness. Neurological damage caused by excessive pressure exerted by the twin during pregnancy progressively led to hearing loss. And like that, my decision was also transformed into a fault of yours. So I must put it right. Do I have any other secrets? Unfortunately, yes, but a letter is too cold for such matters. Now that you know that I can speak, please go to the dark room. I have a hidden recording. Listen to it and you will hear my voice. Farewell, Martha. Why all of this madness, Martha? What else have you been hiding from me? You deprived me of your voice for more than 15 years. I can't wait to hear it now. There is nothing here.
Hi, Julia. I know that this will seem absurd, but this is... We are equals in this sense, too. Well, it's obvious, really. I've basically always spoken, and you were my voice. I'm going to meet my fate, so I don't want there to be any more secrets between us. I have to tell you that I'm pregnant, Julia. I'm pregnant with Lapo's baby. We had sex, and I never had the courage to tell you. I was so afraid of hurting you. I'm so ashamed. And now, how can I ever bring this child into the world? The baby is starting to show. Could you tell? That's why I'm no longer getting undressed in front of you. But for how much longer can I hide it? Yesterday, you asked me to go to the lake together early in the morning. You, the sleepyhead. I asked you to switch beds with me, like we did when we were little girls. I got up at dawn and didn't wake you. I put on one of your dresses. I wrote a card to Mother telling her that it was you who was pregnant, not me, and to come and see at the lake. I left it on the desk in her room. Then I felt the need to talk to you, and I remembered the recorder in the darkroom. Go to the lake alone and act as you. I will tell her everything you never had the courage to tell her. I will be your voice. I know how much she's made you suffer over the years. Unlike you, I remember all of the harm she has done to you, and it is my fault. Take my place, sister. You will live a better life, and I will be able to rest in peace, knowing that I at least tried to put right what I have done wrong. I will go now. My last memory will be the image of you sleeping peacefully.
Hi, Julia. I was upset. Unbelievably upset. July 16th, that cursed day. Martha didn't wake me up. There was a dress missing from my wardrobe. Martha wasn't there, and we were supposed to go to the lake together. She even made her bed, which was unusual. I thought Mother woke up early, despite her medication, and asked her to do something. It was late. Martha hadn't woken me up as we had agreed, and I always overslept. I simply decided to go out and take the photographs by myself without Martha. It was a foggy morning, but it was no longer dawn. It was a sign of something terrible. My mother had killed her beloved Martha with her own hands. I had then taken her place, usurping the throne of her affection. She would have never forgiven me. I had real reason to be afraid. One of Daddy's pistols to defend myself. What a stupid little girl I was. In spite of everything, that roll of film still needed developing, even if it didn't prove she was guilty. I also wanted to search for proof of Martha's pregnancy. I mustn't care about what people think. Or will prevent me from facing them. It will be very difficult to recover from the mental collapse. Destiny is inevitable. The end waits for us.
Phase the troops of the 8th. Units of an Indian division cross the river Pesa on a vast front.
General Edic K.
They advanced 2 kilometers south of Monte Lungo. Meanwhile, the New Zealand units have reinforced their positions that run from
Shell to the Princeton zone shooting clouds and indoors.
Where General K was staying was bombed by the artillery. The general and his family were not in the house at the time of the attack, and once again, Namala has been the site of a farm was stormed and animals were stolen and killed. But it claimed responsibility for yet another act of senseless vandalism. At the scene, an anti-gun propaganda. This is
probably the wrong number. I'm
I'll leave it in the letterbox. Have a good day.
Another telegram of condolence. Isn't it a bit late? The New Zealanders conquer Tavernelli in the eastern sector of the battlefront. The troops of the 2nd New Zealand Division, British 8th Corps, conquer Tavernelli. The 6th South African Armoured Division advances on the heights near Greve, conquering the peaks of the Dimini and Philly Mountains. The 4th Division reaches San Giovanni. Dear Mrs. Irene K., following your call, we have received a telegram from Dr. D. Your request has been accepted. As soon as the police station issues authorization, we will send for the girl. While we wait, to avoid the girl taking any extreme actions, as per the fears you have expressed, we ask that you trust in the advice of her treating physician. I thank you for your generous and charitable donation to our institution. Director S., Volterra Psychiatric Hospital, telephone 0782. Now that she has discovered everything, she wants to lock me up in an asylum. Or maybe even worse, she wants to kill me and have everyone believe it was suicide. She is preparing all the finer details.
Volterra Psychiatric Hospital, how may I help you?
Hello, we recently requested the admission of Julia Kay to the hospital. I just wanted to know whether it would be possible to cancel the request.
I'm sorry, but the request was issued by the municipality where you reside, madam. Any revocation of the request should be passed by them. Only they can decide whether to give cancellation or not. Have you already received a telegram confirming that we have taken charge of the request?
No, I haven't received any telegram.
Then you must hurry. If you go to the town hall and discuss the issue with them, they can approve the cancellation. Thank you. Goodbye, madam.
Where's the bicycle pump? To go far away from here, I need to have a good reason. Martha is in the family crypt. That place is scary. I don't remember, but Nanny told me we used to go there when we were kids to see who was brave enough to go down the stairs. No one would ever go further than the first two steps. Now Martha's down there, alone, in the dark. She must be frightened. Crypt is here. Not now. Let's hope the caretaker isn't around. That man gives me the creeps. I should water the plants. No one will do it. The caretaker clearly doesn't care. This door is locked, but I must get in. Maybe I can find something around here to break the lock. These are perfect for breaking the lock. I should hurry before the caretaker comes back. Enough. I can't go on like this any longer. I can't go on pretending nothing happened. My family was slaughtered by these dirty Nazis. My daughter wasn't even buried, and I had to bury that half-blood instead. An Italian family that got cozy with the dirty Germans. Bastards, that's what they are. What am I supposed to do with my life now? I want to end it, but not without taking a few Germans down with me. You won't see me anymore. But you will hear about me. Long live the resistance. Viva Italia. Everyone takes a side. I find myself siding with my family, but I'm not sure whether it is right. Now that I have filled the watering can, I can water the plants. Lapo. If you were in front of me, what would I say to you? That I'm angry because you were sleeping with Martha? No, I'm not angry. I'm sorry that you kept everything hidden from me. It stings a little, perhaps, but faced with your loss, everything is now meaningless. I'm happy that they buried you here. We'll be neighbors. I knew that Daddy would allow it, even if you were fighting with the partisans. For him, this war is a stranger as it is for me. Goodbye, Lapo. We will meet again soon. It's time to look for Martha. I can see why we were scared as children. It's a rather gloomy place. May God forgive me for what I'm about to do. I also pray that you, Martha, will forgive me. Martha was pregnant. Pregnant with a deformed fetus with two heads. Twins again. They always said that it ran in the family. I was all the more shocked. I was doing things that I had never done before. I do not know what force was moving me. I became unstoppable. I decided to photograph the horror as evidence to show my mother and to everyone. Who knows why? Enough now. I will torture you no longer. I will come back to fix you, and I will stay and take care of you. We will spend so much time together. I love you, Martha.
Doctor, I must thank you for your help. I wouldn't know what to do without you. Even our own dear Don Attilio seems to not understand the situation.
Irene, please, consider the idea of leaving Italy as your husband suggested. It would be better for everyone, especially for the girl.
I fear that nothing will make her better. Her father doesn't want to accept it. I believe that hope is long gone.
I agree, but in Germany, there are better treatments in specialized clinics. The asylum is a temporary solution, just to ensure that she doesn't do anything foolish. But it's a nightmarish place. You know that all too well. You cannot possibly want this for your daughter.
Of course I don't. But what can I do? She is a danger to herself, to us, to everyone. One of Eric's guns has also disappeared. She must have taken it. Who else could it have been? I am so scared, Doctor. I cannot wait any longer. Also, you know what they think of Italians in Germany, don't you?
But you would be with Eric, an esteemed general. Everyone will respect you.
That cursed girl. Where could she be? Let's hope she doesn't play any more foolish stunts. I'll wait for her here, in the cellar. Sooner or later, she'll go to the dark room. That's for sure.
I would gladly stay and keep an eye on her. But I must rush to town to organize the last few things for her hospitalization.
Thank you, Doctor. Don't worry. We'll see you later.
She's sleeping. I must take advantage of this. I will make her talk. She will reveal the truth out of fear. She thinks I can be silenced by calling me crazy. But unbeknownst to her, I will record everything. Everyone will know what you have done to your own daughter. I would make too much noise and wake her up. Now I will wake her up and she will confess. You can bet on it.
What are you doing, my daughter? Why do you want to ruin your life?
I'm sorry. It wasn't me who just shot Mummy. It wasn't me. Dear God, what have I done? She forced me. She killed Martha. But who in the world will believe me now? They will take me to the mental asylum. Those rolls of film are my only hope. So that's who had the keys to my childhood bedroom. I could have guessed. My God! Sooner or later, more bombs will land here. Then everything will come to an end. At least now I finally have the keys to my old room. But why was it locked in the first place? Finally, I can enter my room. It's like being a child all over again. I used to play with the puppets by reenacting what was happening in my life, to clear my mind. I want to do it again. At the beginning of any puppet act, there was always the legend of the White Lady. Otherwise, the scenes I was reenacting were worthless. According to an ancient legend, the lakes of the area are haunted by the spirit of a young woman who was killed by the man she loved. A lover's nightly tryst by the lake. So much hope and desire. but death, not love, was awaiting her. My love is not here yet. I'll wait. Ah, what a beautiful moon tonight. You're here at last. What's going on? Why are you acting weird?
I know you kissed another.
I would never do that. I love you.
I love you too much. The thought of you with another drives me insane. That's why you have to die. What did I do to you?
In despair, the man confessed he had killed her out of jealousy. They searched everywhere, but the girl's body was never found. Since then, her spirit, known as the White Lady, takes the life of a young woman whenever events take her back to that sad day. Now I can begin. First of all, let's clarify what happened the night before the cursed 16th of July. Dad says we're losing. What will happen if we do? Will we become poor?
Hmm.
Do you want to come with me to the lake tomorrow? I want to take some photos. Let's go at dawn. Mummy sleeps heavily anyway. You know she's been taking that medicine. Wake me up! Did you see Lapo yesterday? I saw him leave the barn. Weren't you there? Sure, great idea. Yes, it happened like this. Then in the morning, Martha went to the lake pretending to be me to show her pregnancy. She knew Mother was going to follow her down. Now I can only guess what happened when they met at the lake.
Take off your clothes. I want to see your shame.
I'm going to kill you. Do you want to hurt me, Mummy? This version is credible. I will never know exactly what happened, but I think I have an idea. And after everything, I shot my mother. No, I didn't shoot. What actually happened? It is all in my mind, but I can remember. I know I can. The little arm. A small leg. And another little arm. Another small leg. Oh, look, only the head is left. I was under the bridge, but it was just a game. This, however, is not a game. I was just playing. It's just a bad joke. Under the bridge, the church, town, speak, the white lady.